your left. Count three individuals beside of you. That gives you a group of four. One of you three are suffering from hunger and food insecurity. Now look to your right. Count nine individuals to your right. One of you is currently suffering from housing insecurity or homelessness. In the United States, in 2012, there were over 21.5 million FAFSAs completed, and it's estimated that roughly 36% to 40% of those students were either hungry or homeless, but only 58,000 of those were identified by colleges and universities that were surveyed. That's a huge discrepancy. In 2018, it is estimated that roughly 42% of students across the country are either hungry or homeless. When you combine four-year and two-year institutions, take away four-year and that number jumps. In two-year institutions alone, 41% of students in the fall of 2017 were identified as hungry and food insecure, either minimally insecure or very insecure, which is the two bottom ranking levels for the U.S. Department of Agriculture's hunger scale. Go to the housing side. Almost half of community college students were identified as housing insecure within the last year across the institutions that were surveyed. Those are alarming numbers. Currently, the research is not there with homeless populations, as this is a population that has just been begun to be studied in the last 5 years. In the last 20 years, we've kind of ignored the issue, but as we've seen student enrollment increase due to initiatives such as Pell Grant increases, grant aid and grant funding from various universities and state facilities, additional students have begun to apply who otherwise were not part of the institution. It's beyond time to bring those individuals into the conversation and ask them what their barriers are. As those of us who work in student affairs and work in academics, we can assume we know the answer to this, but without engaging these individuals directly, which we are currently doing through a research project that interviews these students and individuals, both currently in the institution and those who are not in the institution, to ask them what their story is through ethnographic interviews, where we ask them about their life. What was situations like prior to coming into higher ed? Or through secondary education? Were they able to access post-secondary education or college of any sort? And if not, what were the barriers and why did they not? If they were able to access, what barriers did they have? So I ask you to join me now in working with these students to make it accessible for them. Thanks.